Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel MLT Lectures. In this video, we will discuss about a very important biochemical reaction for the identification of bacteria, that is TSI test or triple sugar ion test. The objective of test is to determine the ability of organism to ferment glucose, lactose and sucrose, and also their ability to produce hydrogen sulfide. Principle of a TSI test is based upon the difference in carbohydrate fermentation pattern and hydrogen sulfide production. Carbohydrate fermentation is indicated by the production of gas and change in the color of the pH indicator from red to yellow color. To facilitate the observation of carbohydrate utilization pattern, TSI agar contains three fermentative sugar, that is lactose, sucrose in 1% concentration and glucose in 0.1% concentration. The phenol red act as a indicator in this test. When the carbohydrate fermentation is detected, the color of the carbohydrate medium changes from orange red to yellow in color. In case of oxidative decarbolization of peptone, alkaline products are built from which the medium converts from orange red to deep red in color. The production of hydrogen sulfide is indicated by black color formation in the butt of the tube. Firstly, the glucose is depleted, then afterwards the organism are able to utilize the lactose or the sucrose. To enhance the alkaline condition of the slant, free exchange of air must be permitted by closing the tube cap closely. TSI agar contains enzymatic digest of casein, enzymatic digest of animal tissue, yeast-enriched peptone, dextrose, lactose, sucrose, that is in the ratio of 1:10:10, ferric ammonium citrate, sodium chloride, sodium thiosulfate, phenol red as an indicator. The pH should be maintained at 7.3. This is the original or unnucleated slant of a TSI, that is orange red color. Procedure to inoculate TSI slant. With a straight inoculation needle, touch the top of the well-isolated colony. Inoculate the TSI by stabbing through the center of the medium to the bottom of the tube and then streak the surface of the slant. Leave the cap loosely and incubate the tube at 35 to 37 degrees centigrade in ambient airflow for 18 to 24 hours. Then examine for the reaction of the medium. Expected result are, first one is an alkaline by acid reaction, that is red slant by yellow butt reaction. It is indicative of dextrose fermentation only. Second, we have acid by acid reaction, that is yellow slant by yellow blood. It indicates the fermentation of dextrose, lactose or sucrose. Third reaction we have is alkaline by alkaline slant, that means red slant by red blood. This is absence of carbohydrate fermentation reaction. Next we can see is blackening of the medium. This occurs when there is a presence of hydrogen sulfide. then we can even see gas production, bubbles or cracks in the agar indicates the formation of or production of gas. Here we can see different kinds of tubes. First one is the control, that is the original color. Second, we have red standby, red part with no gas and hydrogen sulfide production. Next, we have red standby, yellow part with no gas and no hydrogen sulfide. In the fourth tube, there is a yellow slant with the yellow part and there is a small gap between the slant and the part which indicates the production of gas. No hydrogen sulfide produced. Then in the fifth tube, we have yellow slant by yellow part. There is both production of gas as well as hydrogen sulfide. In the last tube, we have red slant by yellow part. That means even there is formation of gas and hydrogen sulfide. This TSI test is used to differentiate member of the enterobacteriaceae family from other gram-negative rods. They are also used to differentiate among enterobacteriaceae family on the basis of sugar fermentation pattern. Thank you. Hope you like the content. The other biochemical reactions link is provided below in the description box. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe the channel.